Thank you for joining us. The University of Arizona Cancer Center at St. Joseph's Hospital and Medical Center in downtown Phoenix is scheduled to open in 2015. It's the latest in a series of new or expanded cancer treatment centers in the Valley. Joining me to talk about the center is Dr. Edward Donahue, Medical Director of the University of Arizona Cancer Center at St. Joseph's Hospital. Dr. Donahue, thank you for joining us on Horizonte. Now, as I understand, you currently have an appointment at St. Joe's and you're practicing oncologist with a focus on breast cancer, is that
right? That's correct, we'll see.
And so, as we noted in the introduction, there are a number of cancer centers that have opened up in the last few years in the Phoenix area. Why this one? Is there really a need?
I believe there is a need. The first cancer center in Arizona was formed in Tucson by the Arizona Cancer Center in the early 1970s. And we saw the Mayo Clinic come to Phoenix several years ago. They have a comprehensive cancer center. And MD Anderson has opened an outpost in the East Valley, which is connected to their organization in Texas. But this is a very large city we live in, and the cancer services have been at the outskirts of the city, you know, North Scottsdale and in the Far East Valley. We have not had a presence in downtown Phoenix.
So this will be the first one that's centrally located.
Yes, and I think it's ironic that it is, and that with Arizona, University of Arizona being the first cancer center in the state, joining forces with the first hospital in Phoenix, you know, St. Joseph's Hospital, which was founded in 1895. So it's a great combination of our clinical services and the research services offered by the University of Arizona.
Now, we've got some artist renderings of the building that's going to be constructed. We're going to put them on the screen now. But give us a sense, as the picture's coming up, for how this is all going to work. There will actually be two sites, right? The one that's pictured there is the one that will be, on Van Buren and...
That'll be at 7th Street and Fillmore.
7th Street and Fillmore.
Yes, and that's the outpatient cancer services which will be provided in this five-story building. And it'll provide a full range of services from outpatient imaging, infusion services for chemotherapy, radiation therapy. There'll be a breast center within the walls of the building, interventional radiology, and cancer-specific specialty areas in 10 or 12 different areas.
And the inpatient care will be provided at St. Joseph's?
That's correct. At St. Joseph's Hospital, we'll provide all of the inpatient services that are necessary for cancer care.
Now, we know that some cancers have higher rates of incidence, or at least mortality rates, in different groups, and one of those is Hispanics. So with respect to breast cancer, tell us about that.
Well, you know, breast cancer is the most common cancer that occurs in women and the second leading cause of death in women in the United States. What we see is that the onset of breast cancer in our Hispanic population, you know, who have moved to the United States, occurs or is detected at a much later rate than it is in people who live here in the United States. And it has to do, I believe, with our Hispanic patients not having the ability to have the screening that is afforded to the other segments of the population. So that most cancers that are found in Hispanic women are detected by them doing self-examination, as opposed to the mammographic detection done in regular type screening. Our focus has been on devising new ways to treat breast cancer, but I think one of our new focus has to be ways to prevent breast cancer from happening, so that we can encourage women to live healthy lifestyles, avoid excessive alcohol, maintain their weight, regular exercise, which we know does reduce one's risk of developing breast cancer.
Now, there's been some controversy in recent years about the efficacy of mammograms, or at least the age when women should have them.
That's correct. And some government standards have recommended that mammograms be performed every 2 years as opposed to annually, as recommended by the American College of Surgeons, the American College of Radiology, and the College of Obstetrics and Gynecology. The one issue with screening on a two-year basis is that in the 40 to 50 age group, where 10 to 15% of breast cancers occur, you are delaying that imaging to a two-year basis rather than on an annual basis, and missing the opportunity to detect those breast cancers at an earlier stage. when they're easier to treat.
So you would be an advocate of more regular screening?
Yes.
So given the location of this cancer center, does that mean that there's a greater likelihood that the population base that it will serve will be Hispanic?
It'll be a part of the population base. You know, we are an inner city hospital, if you will, and our doors are open to all who come to see us, and we anticipate treating everyone, you know, here in the city.
Now let's go back to the genesis of this collaboration. It's been a long time in the making, I understand, maybe 7 or 8 years. How did this come to be?
Well, the dedicated efforts of Linda Hunt and Patty White at St. Joseph's Hospital, and the efforts of the Arizona Cancer Center with Dave Alberts and Tom Brown, plus the support of the Arizona Board of Regents, Stuart Flynn in Phoenix at the College of Medicine, and Weaver Hart, the new president of the University of Arizona. We laid the groundwork over the past several years and just dedicated hard work, many, many hours of discussion and negotiation to make this happen. The groundbreaking we saw earlier today is very exciting because we finally have shovels in the ground, and the building that you showed earlier on the screen will be reality in less than 2 years.
And in terms of the initial staffing, how many people will be employed in the two locations?
Well, the employment ratio at St. Joseph's Hospital will not change. We're going to have outpatient clinics in many different areas of breast cancer care, as I mentioned earlier, and we'll have physicians at the outpatient clinic collaborating with physicians at St. Joseph's Hospital and also with our community physicians throughout the valley. We will be utilizing the talents of all of the specialists throughout the valley who currently work at St. Joseph's Hospital so that their patients can receive the care they require downtown and then go back to their own doctors in different parts of the community.
Dr. Donahue, just a last question. Do you expect we'll see more cancer centers in the Phoenix area after this one is up and running?
I don't believe so.
I think we'll
have the geographic presence of downtown here in the North Valley at the Mayo Clinic, cancer treatment centers in the West Valley, and MD Anderson in the East Valley.
So we've got the valley covered.
I believe we do.
Thank you so much for joining us on Horizonte to talk about this.
Thank you very much.